So our Aboriginal art, we've looked at some of the history and some of the stories. We are going to start with an animal. One of the things that we notice about Aboriginal artwork is there are lots of dots that are used and different lines of color. So I'm going to show you a few different ways that we can go ahead and see the dots and the color with our animals. This is not the only way that you can go ahead and do it, but we're going to look at it using different materials that we do have. Using our crayons and our crayon resist with our markers, going about it with just our markers. But to start with, choose your animal. You have to draw it out. Symmetry comes into play here. We had just looked at several different ways to use symmetry in artwork, and we had done that with our insects. If you wanted, you could go ahead and use the same shape you did for your insects with this, but you do not have to. Thinking, might do a lizard. Now, I don't want it to take up my whole page because I want to have room around the outside. That's where my different lines and dots are going to come in with my patterns. So I'm going to start with that a little bit smaller. Lizard head. Come in here with the body. And the tail. Just gonna make my lizard a little less symmetrical, which is okay. They don't have to be symmetrical because that was not our focus with this project. Notice how I'm fixing my lines before I'm going in to erase them. I'm drawing where I want them to be. So that way I'm erasing what I don't want. All right, so let's do my lizard fingers and the arms. All right. Body. And I'm going to do the shape of my lizard as a silhouette, which means I'm not going to worry about all of the details like we did last time. It's going to just be the shape. It's one of the things that we noticed when we looked at the artwork. The animals themselves had their own designs inside, but it wasn't what you would expect to see. So here's my lizard. What I want to start with first are some rings around it that I can use for color. So I'm going to trace with my permanent marker the whole outline, because when I add my colors, I do not want what I'm doing with my other colors to interfere with the shape of my lizard. So these are just suggestions. This is not at all how you have to create it. So I'm going to start with my outline. There we go. So here's my laser outline. I'm gonna come back and clean this up a little bit. So around the outside is where we're gonna go ahead and add the stripes of color with our dots. So to do that, first I'm gonna do my resist with my markers. So I'm gonna choose a darker color and I'm gonna trace around it, leaving space. I'm not going to worry about the details. I did a really wide, very, very loose loop around it. Now, what would take more time, and I'm not going to do all of it, is I'm going to come in and outline right around my lizard as well, because it's that space in between. Here's what I mean by resist. I pick a very different color with my crayon. I can add my dots, and as I go in and color, my markers will actually push the marker. I'm sorry, my crayons will actually push the marker away, because there is wax and oil in the color in the crayons that our markers will not stick to. Now, as I add my dots, they are not perfectly round. They're all different sizes. So as I do this, and I come back, and I go about coloring around them, as you get to the edge with the wax, you can see where that pushes away the color. Now be careful, because as the crayon gets built up on the tip of the marker, it may stop drawing. So you want to be careful about that. Another way that we can do this is by painting it in. So as we're going in and adding our color over top, we can use our water to wash the color off of our crayon. Now, the way that this works, let me grab my brush in just a second, because what we are going to do is very carefully, with our water, go over our crayon, and we can move our marker color. So notice how, as we do this, our marker color is not wanting to stick to the crayon. I'm taking my time with this. I could also, with my finger, move my purple around. So after you've gone all the way around, this is one way to go ahead and do your dots and add your colors. Another way, markers again, this time we're gonna go ahead and we're gonna dot with our paint. I'm gonna do the same thing. finishing any of these because you do not want to sit there and just watch me color. That's silly. I will go back and finish it so you can see how it looks. Turning my paper because I want to be careful about where I've added water. If I go in with my blue and it touches where I've already added water, it's going to blend and bleed those colors together. So I need to be careful about that as I'm working. That might have been a little bit close there. We'll have to see how that turns out. So my dots. Lots of different colors. I'm actually going to use pencil eraser. Not my whole paint, just the lid, because I don't want a lot. I want just a little bit. So when I touch the top of it, I have just enough that I can dot, 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 before I need to pick up another one. What you are going to notice as you go through is your paint is going to pick up some of your marker color. Think about that when you're making the choices. You may want to go back over them. You may want to let them go ahead and pull that color in. I'm going to hold this top because that's going to drive me nuts. That clicks and sticks every time you re-ink. So it's almost just like stamping. So with stamps, it doesn't matter how many times you press it down, it only inks the very raised surface. The same with the paint. We don't want to swirl it around. We're not digging at the paint. We don't want it all clumped up. We just want to be able to add our dots to it. In between, best way to clean it off, having a cloth or a damp paper towel, you can just wipe the paint right off your eraser and keep going. Now, different tools have different size dots. So, if I chose to do another layer, and I'm gonna turn it so you can see, because we're just going to use a dull pencil. I leave my white as the background. I can dip and I get smaller dots. You're also going to notice that as you dot more and more, they get smaller as you start to run out of paint. These are some of the techniques. Oh, I have a whole extra dot there. We are going to use as we make our rain stick. So I want you to experiment with different sizes of dots, different ways you're going to create your designs as you're working your way all the way around your animal. So some of you may have chosen a kangaroo or a bird. It works the same. Now after you've done one or two rows, maybe three or four, let it dry for a little bit, because as you go from here out to the edge, they do not have to just follow around your animal. One of the things that we saw with the Dreamtime artwork and the Aboriginal art is they used lines as a form of direction. So your lines may start going around your animal, but they may not continue that way. So these lines are coming off the page this way. And also, you may have some other directions. Looking at the symbols that we saw in Aboriginal art, circles are a very important aspect of rest, of camp, of home, and they are used frequently in Aboriginal art. Now, if I choose to do dots, but I don't want to worry about paint, I want to come in, I can use my darker color markers as well. So look at how they use lines and dots. And work on filling your page. There are lots of different ways to do this between crayon and marker. Also going in and adding our water to turn it into more of a paint, so we have that variation in color. Drawing markers over markers, adding crayon over markers. Use the materials that you have. Even your finger can be used as a stamp. If you color the edge and stamp it, you have a dot, and that can absolutely be used. To create part of your design. Using the idea of Aboriginal artwork, experiment with your colors, experiment with your dots and your lines, using some of the symbols that we see in traditional Aboriginal artwork. See how it all comes together and what you can create with your animal. All right, I can't wait to see what you guys come up with, and we will go ahead and work on our rain stick next. The rain stick being the instrument that is decorated on the outside with some of the traditional symbols that we've seen in the artwork. And I have those for you to look at too. All right, have fun.